and grateful that Barack Obama inspired that girl, because she's my niece, Tanisha Ray Johnson. Tanisha was given hope and inspiration just like millions of other children and young people across this nation. They see him as a good man. They look up to him. They also see the efforts to tear him down. We cannot let the Tea Party Republicans and the Koch brothers and their millions destroy this president. We cannot let them destroy the hopes and dreams of this generation. America's children need Barack Obama to succeed. They deserve an America where hope triumphs over hate. They deserve an America where everyone has access to affordable health care. They deserve an America where the economy works for the middle class and those struggling, not just the richest 1%. They deserve an America that is respected worldwide. They deserve an America that values knowledge and education and teachers. They deserve an America that honors unions for creating the vast middle class, not trying to destroy them. They deserve an America that honors the police and firefighters, not just on 9/11, but by keeping our word and providing our first responders the fair print pension that we promised them. They deserve an America that provides every returning veteran and their family the support they need. They deserve an America that gives hope to every child, no matter their economic circumstances, their gender, their color, or who they will love. They deserve an America that encourages and embraces every child to be the best that they can be. They deserve an America that keeps the promise of with liberty and justice for all. And let us be clear, they will not have that America with Newt Gingrich, Michelle Bachmann, or Mitt Romney, or any of those seeking the Republican nomination. If you truly believe that America's children deserve that America of their hopes and dreams, then you must do everything you can to re-elect Barack Obama, President of the United States. And that starts right here in Georgia. I don't want to hear any excuses. If President Obama carries Georgia in 2012, it is not possible for him to lose the election. You have that power, Georgia. Now it's up to you. It's up to you to build that vehicle, that victory mobile. Step one, build the engine by increasing your financial support of the state party. Whatever you gave tonight, you give it again in September. And ask those who didn't show up tonight to give as well. Step two is to build the frame by revitalizing your local Democratic organizations this year. Don't wait to next September or next October to start thinking about it. Do it this year. You need to bring new people in and engage them and empower them and encourage them to bring other new people in. You should not be afraid of more people being part of your local organization. They are the ones that are going to lift you to victory. Step three. Locate the tires. Make sure that everyone who is eligible to vote is registered to vote. Stay in touch with them and make sure they vote on election day. They've got far more serious things going on in their lives. They do not know when election day is. Don't be fooled. You have to remind them and remind them why it's important to their families and their future. There are enough registered, unregistered voters in the state of Georgia for Democrats to sweep in 2012 in Georgia. And it's up to you to get that done.